Building something that looks great in the visual layout editor is the easy part. You also need to consider different screens and orientations. As you begin to lay out your UI, there's a temptation to build it pixel perfect for the device you happen to be using at the time. This is reinforced by the fact that your app's window doesn't generally change size while it's running. So you can't just grab the lower right corner and grow and shrink your app to see how it behaves. But if you've ever developed for the web or desktop, you know this static approach is a bad idea. When Android first launched, HVGA 480 by 320 resolution screens were standard. As we began exploring how to build engaging user experiences on those devices, we could use absolute layouts to define the exact location of each screen element. But within a year, the first WVGA Android phones were released. And now Android runs on everything from phones to phablets, tablets, TVs, and wearables, with any screen size, resolution, and aspect ratio you could imagine. So, just like desktop or web, where you might use panels or CSS, your Android UI needs to scale based on the screen it's running within, which is why Absolute Layout was deprecated. In favor of layouts like linear layout, relative layout, and grid layout, that can dynamically resize and adapt to any screen following the principles of responsive design.